All right, this is NASCAR Xfinity Series iRacing, week 10 at Daytona International Speedway. I am the number 6 car. I did not qualify because I know there's always going to be a wreck, and I didn't want to be a part of it, so I tried to be toward the back end of the pack, but nobody else qualified either, so I ended up being somewhere in the middle. Anyhow, this was a race I entered on Sunday night. Had some family over to watch the Daytona 500, but as those of us that watch NASCAR know, it was delayed for rain until Monday. So I just bought the movie Ford versus Ferrari, so showed the family that, and afterwards my nephew wanted to see me do a race. So that's why I'm not talking. I'm bullshitting with him during the race. So this is a paint scheme I created in trading paints based on a couple different NASCAR, Marine Corps sponsored NASCAR race cars in the early 2000s. I think it came out okay. I really like it. I did this for a couple of the cars, a couple of the dirt cars, as well as tried to do one for the IndyCar. The IndyCar is a little problematic in trading paints, but that's a story for another time. So hopefully you enjoy the race, and I'll see you at the end. Bye.
You know what I heard from the cars? Gibberish, dab, jabberish, chip, chip, jab, jewel, job. That's what I heard.
Alright, so when we're coming to the green, we're all going to come back down pit road and wait for a half hour for the track to dry. And then we're going to do 2 laps and then wait for the track to dry again.
The 2 laps have to be at 70 miles an hour. No left, no more.
Sounds good.
Single file, too. Single file.
You cracked. You cracked, though.
Look, we've got the lap pack. You uncocked it?
Oh, yeah, better get a jet out.
I absolutely love that comment. I'm kind of rump off. I wasn't born there, but I lived half a life, and that commercial made it was better than any Doritos commercial ever.
Garbage.
Yeah, Michael, I don't know why in the world they thought it was a good idea to take
the green flag, next time by. Line up on the inside. This road is closed. Get stop soon, stop.
Still there.
Stay low.
file.
Pit road is closed.
Let the gate job on.
You entered a closed pit.
Yeah,
go to the end of the longest line. Line up single file. Pit road is closed. Right,
no, let the one job on.
Check them up.
Hey, number two, it's telling me to go past you. Or you to pass me.
Okay, third car's gonna be on the back stretch.
Catch the one car.
And half the field pitted. Everyone stay low because the eight's gonna have to go by everyone. What up? See ya.
My God, after all that, all they have is 15 seconds of optional repairs.
Andrew, are you inside of the pace car?
Oh, yes, I am.
That's funny as shit looking.
It doesn't look too good, does it?
Where are you, number 8?
You ready to see something really funny? Ready?
I'm ready.
Alright, I'm finished.
Did you have fun?
Yeah, it's pretty nice. When you go inside the pace car, you can actually see the teeth of the driver. It's pretty creepy.
Yeah, like, why the hell would they do that much, like, modeling?
I just love trying to follow the pace car, inside the pace car. Can you see me entirely?
Right now I can see.
That's it, go!
And now I can, you're starting to disappear. Now you're gone.
Okay.
Line up single file.
Catch the 13 car.
Right. Catch the 15, Kyle. Okay, bud, green flag, next time by. Line up on the inside. Catch the 15, Kyle. Catch the 8, Kyle.
Cool. If you get into one of those, give me a good word.
Absolutely.
I'm only 1 year older than when William Byron started, so it's nice.
Yeah, I'm actually kind of old for it, but it's just, I mean, it's just the way shit's working out with sponsors and stuff, they're switching directions and stuff like that, so.
For ARCA, you don't have to, unless you're young and you know you're going to go into the Cup Series or whatever, or you're just going to try, after the age of 20, you don't really have a shot at going all the way up from the young guns, from the early series like ARCA and Gander.
Right, yeah, so we're going to do probably partial season of Gander, partial season of ARCA, try to go to Xfinity the following year, but I'm also working a GTD program in IMSA. In the Acura NSX GT3s.
Yeah, seriously.
That's it, go!
Put in a good word for me. I really love that.
Let's go, man.
Ready, line up on the inside. Catch the 19 shot. Stay hard, please. Green flag, green flag.
I've heard of it, I never really looked it up. I was thinking about registering
I do some on the speedway, so it's only like an hour and a half north of me, but I don't know if I need money, how much money I need for it. You need a lot?
Oh, you have to have your own car, but you can probably get in for under 10 grand, the trailer and so.
5 laps to go.
You can better get expensive tires.
Yeah, racing is super expensive.
Yeah, it's extremely expensive.
Don't do it, Ace. Don't do it. No!
Oh, don't do that three wide. Don't do that three wide.
Do it.
Better fall back in line, Ace.
CCA, and it's just a blast.
You go high. Thank you. From the start finish line. So close.
Man, that was a... Yeah, Andrew, I'm kind of pushy, but man, when I get to your bumper, it's like, when I hit you square, it's just that your car gets all crazy.
Are you hitting me at full throttle?
No, I'm kind of glide up to your bumper, and when I get into your bumper, I feel like... get gradual on the throttle when I get to you.
What you should do is when you get like right near me, just get like half throttle for a second and then hit. That doesn't turn me or give me squirrely. So I gotta check. I'm checking that big time for like 7.5 seconds. Because he stays at pace speed. He never goes up or below or above. And then that happens.
Oh, I didn't know that.
16
you
yards.
You close to
alive.
Go to the end of the longest line.
You're fucking incredible. You're hitting everything else.
The pace car is invincible, so that can't happen.
Thank you, Captain.
I don't know what is up with the NBA All-Star game, but it is, they changed it again.
What did they change?
The NBA All-Star game, it's the format. Like, they have quarters, it's still four quarters, but you win quarters. So after a quarter, you get...
That's it, go!
No matter quarter, you get a win, a tally to your team, and at the end, or whatever.
Line up single file, Linda 19, Skyborn. Linda 7, Skyborn.
Big time goalie that y'all had actually started in Birmingham at the Birmingham Bulls, and I met him. I used to play ice hockey as a kid, and I'd play like my first period to start before theirs, and then between one and two, my second period, and I'd play games in between theirs.
I don't know exactly where my the players on that team, their colleges or whatever, or their previous teams. I'm not a big follower of that. I never actually looked it up. But I've been a Bruins fan since I could walk.
Pasta, 19, Cubs.
Yeah, I never done any other sports. I had ice hockey and flag football. They did baseball too slow for me.
Green flag, check time by. Line up on the inside. Catch it up, 21, Cubs. Pasta, 20, Cubs.
The only reason that the Blues won last year was that room, if they would have lost that room, they would have been devastated. The people knew.
Dude, we've got the 70 years. That's what I'm saying. I used to watch that room. I'm not there again, man. I was like, third year. That's never, just like being the worst one to make up for the story of my life.
Catch up, 21, John.
Yeah, that's a shame with me, the Bruins. I'm so glad that they're killing it this year. I'm glad that they were good last year, but still, they don't need to be in the final.
Catch up, 21, Cop.
Because they're confident they're the best team in the NHL right now.
Yeah, they ain't no good.
I gotta check who's the worst team in the NHL, and then I can figure out who will play in the finals.
Like last year, it was the Blues.
Yes, sir. You want a hole, Brian?
Get ready, go green.
Man, I'm just here for the SR.
Can you give me a push to the win?
Yeah,
eight cars in. That car is a lap down, outside. Stop. Inside. They're inside.
Yeah,
It's over.
Dude.
Yeah, we'll get them next time.
So it's in the border, man. They both need one. I just want Lord to come to the interviews and I want to see all the parties.
I was in Clash last week, and I was so mad when Larson left Chase. He needs to win tomorrow.
22, buddy. If you would have stayed high on the backstretch, I would have shoved you as much as I could, man.
All right, so I got wrecked. It was kind of my fault. I hung back a little bit, but I kind of arc a braked right into this number 17 car here. I thought I should have got on the brakes, but usually when you get on the brakes, you get ran the hell over. Anyways, it looks like the 18 came down, and it kind of friggin' netcoded with the 17. Because he does legitimately knock the 9 out. He basically bucks the 9 out of line. And then I think the computer read that there was some contact between the 18 and the 17 that there wasn't really there. You could see, well, I'd say in real life, that'd probably be about 2 foot gap, but it turns to 17 anyways. And that's what gets everything going. And then the 17 makes contact with the 2, and it pushed it right in my way. Yeah, I should have turned down to the grass, down to the apron a lot quicker. And I should have got on the brakes. I just basically just stayed on the throttle, was hoping to be able to get by, get through it, but that's not the case, obviously. See, from this perspective, you can kind of see the 17 kind of comes out of nowhere. Now, it's my fault, for sure. When I saw those two cars hitting the wall there, I should have just turned onto the apron. I started seeing those cars coming down, and right here's where suddenly, but it was too late by now. I was on the brake a little bit, but not enough. And I wasn't turned down to the apron. I knew, though, getting on the grass, you can lose it real quick. So, I don't know. It was kind of out of my control, I guess. But, yeah, so maybe next time Daytona or Talladega comes up, I'll have some better luck. But that's about it. So, yeah. Well, until next time, you guys have a good one. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.